reaction I couldn't have hoped for. As we sit here tonight, in a small town or a big city somewhere, at this very moment, a young pianist is practicing her heart out, sacrificing her entire life for a nearly impossible goal, a desire to make a dream her life's work. What drives her most is almost impossible to define, but the reward for her single-minded passion comes to fruition when she walks on stage at Severance Hall to perform with the Cleveland Orchestra, and the world sits in awe. This is what we are about. This is what we help achieve. Welcome to the Cleveland International Piano Competition. My name is Pierre van der Westhuizen, and I have the great privilege of being the president and CEO of the CIPC. Welcome to this historic event for the CIPC, the third concert in our 2014 series, our four spectacular 2013 medalists with the sensational Apollo's Fire Baroque Orchestra. I'd also like to welcome all those tuning in to our webcast, as well as the WCLV audience. The CIPC has been achieving a remarkable vision since 1975. We have consistently brought the world's most promising pianists to Cleveland, offering them the opportunity to compete in front of enthusiastic audiences and an international jury, and giving audiences nearly 2 weeks of exquisite music making. It is an inspiration for the community and has many times been a catalyst for lifelong friendships that span the globe. By virtue of making it to the final round of the 2013 competition, the four gentlemen you will hear this afternoon had the privilege of playing with the Cleveland Orchestra at Severance Hall. CIP's partnership with the orchestra is extraordinary, and contestants, critics, and audiences have embraced it as an event highlight since it was first forged in 2003. Last year, we joined forces with the wonderful Cleveland Museum of Art, a move that allowed us to soar to new heights by holding performances in this beautiful hall, adding a festival, and using the museum's atrium for social events. We very much look forward to continuing both these wonderful partnerships in the years ahead. I hope your takeaway from this very short introduction is that the CIPC has grown to become far more than just an event. It is now a much-loved Cleveland institution. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with our literature at the information table in the lobby and to discover how you can get involved and lend your support. Now, one last thing. I would like to just take a moment to thank all of you here for making this possible, including the generous patrons who are here for our Crescendo Gala. I would also like to thank our presenting sponsors, Art of Beauty, Jerry Murphy and Molly Dixon, the Frank H. and Nancy L. Porter Fund of the Cleveland Foundation, and our special presenting sponsors for this evening, Audrey and Albert Ratner. Thank you also to Anne Ames, our magnificent chair of tonight's benefit, and Darcy Kovach, who has worked tirelessly and through the night to make this a big success. Thank you. And if you'll allow me, I would also take a moment to just recognize the generous patrons who helped these four winners you'll hear tonight achieve their dreams. Dick and Carol Kaufman, Dick and Connie Emanuel, Barbara Evanchik. Both Barbara and Dick passed away earlier this year, and we remember them fondly tonight. And also Barbara and Mel Mixon, whose generous support of the Mixon First Prize has now increased to a jaw-dropping $75,000 for 2016. Bravo to all of you, and thank you so much for helping these people achieve their dreams. Thank you. I'd like to just quick housekeeping, if you take a minute to turn off your cell phones, anything that beeps or vibrates. And then now I would like to welcome to the stage the winners of the 2013 CIPC and Jeanette Sorel and the wonderful Apollo's Fire.
Thank you.